Hi, in this video I will demonstrate a really amazing use case. I will show you how you can combine the ideation mode, the brainstorming app inside InfraNodus that visualizes a text as a network and shows you what are the main ideas and gaps between them, with the new tool for coding that's called Cursor AI. But we will use this tool not for writing code, but for writing SEO-friendly articles. So we will first generate some ideas using the knowledge graph inside InfraNodus, then we'll take the most interesting aspects of those ideas out, put them into Cursor AI, and use its composer mode to generate a really interesting article that will be rich in content. And then we will take this article back into InfraNodus, analyze it once again, identify the gaps inside, generate some interesting prompts and questions that we can paste back into Cursor AI to make this article even better. And then I will even show you how you can use Grok AI to generate some images for this article so you can publish it online. So if you're interested to learn how it works, keep watching and I will demonstrate step by step. Also, please subscribe to this channel so that this video can get recommended to other people interested in the same stuff. To begin, I will explain to you what my problem is. I have a website that I recently made that's called Sassy Tools. It's tools for SaaS software as service, and it provides some really interesting metrics for companies to analyze in order to know what will be their revenue flow, how much they get from each customer, and so on. And now I have a task that I need to attract audience to this website. So I need to create some articles that would be SEO friendly, that would talk about those topics. And I can write them myself, but I want to show you how you can actually do this using the AI and do this in a way that would make sure that you cover all the topics that would be interesting to your potential customers. And in order to do that, I will go back to InfraNodus and I will go to the apps page. And by the way, if you want to check this tool that I created, I will leave a link in the description to the video so you can also test it out yourself. And I will go back to InfraNodus, go to brainstorm ideas and apps, so that will be the brainstorming mode. And I will type in the keyword that relates to my ideas. So in this case, it's SaaS, LTV, and I will also write tools because it's SaaS tools and LTV is one of the metrics that's proposed. And then I click on AI generated and I go into the live AI ideation mode. So that's the mode that we'll use to ideate. And then I'll create a new name for this graph, InfraNodus. Click save, and what happens here is that InfraNodus will visualize my text as the nodes, the words are the nodes, and the co-occurrences are the connections. So this is the logic, it builds a graph, and then based on this representation, it will identify the main ideas and the gaps. And then it uses the built-in AI to generate some statements that relate to my initial idea. So here I have, for example, an explanation of what LTV is, right, and how it helps forecast revenue and customer insights over their life cycles. And then it provides also some other tools that actually already do that. So that's good for me. I can save it into the graph and have it move on. I can have it generate more responses based on this initial idea. So for example, here it says how they can significantly enhance long-term value by optimizing customer engagement and retention strategies. Why not? Let's add this also. But what you can also do is to already use this structural insights that InfraNodus provides to have the built-in AI start bridging the gaps between those ideas. So for example, here it says term optimization and analytics lifecycle. And then I click this button here, so it uses the context of the original text to generate another idea. And as you can see, it's kind of really short statements, which is much better for ideation than long texts that ChatGPT creates, because you actually have time to review them and to interact with them and to maybe add some of your own ideas. So for example, here it says that how optimizing long-term strategies with tools like chart model, bear metrics, and profit well enhances SaaS LTV significantly by providing detailed analytics on customer engagement and revenue throughout the life cycle. So we do this, we add this information, and then I want to show you also how you can manually identify gaps. So for example, here, if I click on the blind spots, it will show me the gaps in the discourse. What are the topics that could be better connected? And once it shows me this gap, I can generate a research question using the AI, and then I can think of the answer to this question, or I can have it answer it for me. And then I will click on chat here. So it's going to answer this question. And if I like this answer, I can add it both into the graph, so I can kind of keep on iterating. But also, once I get something I find interesting, I can also save it into my project notes. And that's what we'll be using to actually generate the Cursor article, because I don't want to use all these ideas that we generated before here for the article, because it's just some kind of building blocks. I actually want to choose the best ideas, and then based on those best ideas, then I will generate an article with Cursor AI. So I will just go a few more iterations, asking InfraNodus to identify the gaps and to generate some interesting insights for me based on those gaps. For example, here we have a gap between customer analytics, I talked about that, and metric integration with other tools, but maybe there was not enough connections here. So here's proposing me a question that would link those two topics together. And I will click on elaborate, chat, and then get an interesting answer to that question. And here, if I like it, I can save it into the graph so that I can continue ideating on this topic and also save it to my notes so I can later use it for my Cursor AI article. And I would do this in a few iterations, but now for the sake of brevity, I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna show you what you do to switch to Cursor AI to actually start writing this article. So one thing that I like to do before I go to AI summarize and I ask the whole system to kind of summarize everything and then save it into my notes as well. In fact, I will move this at the top of the notes so the system knows a little bit better that it's kind of like these are the main ideas. And then I will also ask it to auto-generate from analytics some insights that it created, right? So there it's going to take all those topics and main ideas that were identified, the main keywords, and create some kind of like a summary based on that. So now I have two good ideas in relation to this text, a summary here at the top and the main ideas here at the bottom. Now I click this button, generate an outline based on those notes. And here I already have like a name for the article. So for example, I can get rid of this long-term thing and just keep it like that. Maximizing SaaS profitability, leveraging analytics tools for customer engagement and revenue forecasting. And here it's talking to me about the different LTV tools like Chartmogul, Barometrics, and ProfitWell, how to enhance customer engagement, leveraging integrated analytics, and so on. So here I have an outline of a potential article. I'm going to copy this outline, and then I'm going to go to Cursor AI. And if you don't know what that is, it's actually a coding tool, but it has a really great AI module that can analyze your whole database and generate text based on that. So I'm going to create a new file. I'm gonna call it SAS LTV value txt, and then I'm gonna paste this outline that we created. It will automatically try to format it in the right way. I can also go into the word wrap and make sure this is on, and then I need to create a new chat in composer. So to open the composer, I have to click command L, and then I go into the composer mode and I create a new chat. I tell it what will be the context. So in this case, I'm just going to use this file itself, right? But if I wanted to, I could also add other files I have in the same folder, which is pretty amazing, because imagine you can have a folder of your articles and just use that as context. So then your articles will get more and more precise and much more elaborated. And I don't actually know why people don't use Cursor for writing texts. I think it's a really amazing tool because it's one of the best AIs out there. And then it's gonna copy this, so here I'll say, okay, let's remove this actually. So I say, use this context, and then I will say, write a SEO-friendly article on the topics outlined in this file. And I can be in the normal mode for now, then click submit, and then Cursor AI will generate an article. And as you can see, it's already adding markdown formatting. So that's great. I already have headlines, which are really good for search engine optimization, SEO, and also I have a whole text, right? And you see it's rewriting the article based on the outline I created with InfraNodus, which is pretty amazing. Then I click accept all. It's going to be accepted here. It also generated a list of keywords, which is pretty great. And now I can look at this article, and of course I can read through it and add some fixes, but I want to show you how we can enhance it further by adding it back into InfraNodus. So I'm going to copy this article, I'm going to go back to InfraNodus, and then I'm going to create a new graph, and I'm going to paste this plain text here. And what's going to happen is that InfraNodus will visualize this article that was generated by Cursor AI, and it will show me what are the main topics inside, right? So I see here it's focused on customer retention, engagement, and so on, revenue analytics. But what I'm interested in is to identify the gaps inside. So I'm going to go to the blind spots here, and then here it shows me some topics that could be better connected. I can turn this on to have the names of those topics shown, and then I can ask it to show me more gaps. And usually I would look for the clusters that are further apart from each other. So for example, here, business analytics and retention strategy. I'm going to ask it generate a question based on the context, right? So I have this clicked. It generates a question. I take that question, which is actually asking us how can integrating SaaS analytics tools to monitor and analyze regular product and customer engagement metrics, reveal opportunities for sustainable growth through enhanced lifetime value and strategic resource allocation. So it's kind of like this idea of how you can make your business grow sustainably by using all those metrics, which is an interesting question. And we didn't talk about it in the same context in this text. This is why the system generated it. So I'm going to take that question and I will use it as a prompt back in Cursor AI. And I can just tell it using the question below, modify the text in this file. And maybe I will say to include the answer. Okay, click submit, and Cursor AI will rewrite this for me automatically. And by the way, Cursor AI, I think it has a free version, so you can actually start using it already now. You just download it on your computer and open it in a folder. You can even add some text files, like maybe you're working on a research or something, so you just add those text files in there. If you have PDFs, you'll probably have to convert them into text files first. You make a folder so it knows the context better, and then it's gonna respond much better. And then I'm gonna click accept, and here I already have a quite nice article that covers a lot of different topics. What I don't like is that it has this bullet point, so I will also ask it make the article a bit more human-like by removing those bullet points and instead turning them into plain text sentences. Also, make each section longer. Okay, click enter. It's going to read my instruction. It has the context of this file already, so it's going to use that, right? And now you see it's generating, it's telling me what it's doing. So this is great. You see it's rewriting it in a way that it doesn't have these bullet points, but rather human readable sentences, which is also better for SEO. And here we go. I have already something really nice as like an outline of the article, some bullet points at the bottom still, which I can ask it to fix, and also some plain text as well, right? So this is good. I can even now say, okay, let's add more things in the context. So I'm gonna also say, add this, and maybe also SAS new, but I don't think there's something there, but let's try. Oh yeah, let's also add this inside. And as you can see now, it has this file and also three files actually. And I will say, using the context, now modify this article to include all ideas that are not yet in this file, SAS LTV value into it. Okay, so it will modify the context, and we're integrating the key ideas from the other context files. It's actually saying to you here what it's doing to generate more stuff. And now you see we have a much more content here. It also is rewriting those bullet points that we didn't want to have, which is great. And then we click accept all, and now we have a really nice article. Of course, I would read it and fix it myself because I don't like the stuff that are generated by machines, but that could be a good beginning for me to kind of see how I can develop it further. And then I would even take it again back into InfraNodus, visualize it again in order to see if it covers all the topics I need and to see the gaps inside. So I'm visualizing it here. I can see that it's still focused on this idea of the customer, analytic tools, and so on. So for example, the word customer here takes too much attention, so I'm gonna hide it temporarily to see the context around. I see that there is the topics on analytics integration, business metrics, revenue planning, growth, sustainability. Great. Like, this is kind of like an overview of the main topics in my document. And you have more also predictive analytics, company performance, revenue expansion, and so on. And then I can again look at the gaps, see if there is something missing that could be connected in a new way. Let's reiterate through them. For example, here I see that these two clusters are quite far apart from each other, resource optimization and ecosystem growth. Generate insight question. Copy it. It says, how can SaaS companies integrate feature adoption and team support metrics with data-driven approaches to forecast revenue? Great. Actually, it's true. Like, I haven't thought of this before, but it's a great idea to integrate those metrics on user interactions and team support in order to see how they can improve their revenue and make it all more or less automatized. So I'm going to give it back to the system, add an answer to this question in the text. And this is how you would approach it. You would do this in an like iterative way. So you would generate ideas here in InfraNodus based on the gaps, then bring them back to Cursor AI, generate text, and so on. And once you feel like you're ready, then you have a text. And of course, you don't have to generate everything like I did automatically here, because I did that to make that video shorter. Of course, I could use the same process just by writing ideas myself and then using those AI tools to just help me steer in a certain direction. But I would actually end up writing the text myself, because I like reading stuff that are written by humans, actually, right? But it's just to show you the concept. I think it's really good. It's kind of like it really increases productivity and also solves this blank sheet problem that you don't know where to start, and also enables you to see how you can cover most territory of the ideas that you're interested in. So I'm going to accept this, and as you can see, now we have a nice article, and it should be SEO optimized because it has this main titles and so on. And now we can post it on the website that we have in some blog section. I created it actually using Bolt, I think, or V0 Versal. And so I can just give the instruction to this other AI tool to generate a blog section, and then I add this in, and we already have some content that can start attracting potential customers to this site. So this would be the workflow. Try it out, see how that works. Also, please leave your opinion in the comments to this video below. Also, if you have any questions, and if you like that workflow, and if I see that there's interest, I would also build an extension for Cursor AI and Windsurf AI, because it's based on the same ecosystem, that you could actually do all this inside the tool itself. So you wouldn't have to switch between InfraNodus and Cursor. So if you're interested in that, also please let me know so that I know there is interest and that I can put time into building this stuff. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed.